This is my third take, or rather, third attempt at making a video. Unfortunately, I keep on getting so excited and into what I'm trying to say, I forget about that little thing right there, and I end up distracting myself by bumping into it. I would move it, but I feel so good with this little heat wave. Actually, it's just normal August temperatures that we're having right now. I can't complain. It's been such a beautiful summer. What's a little heat wave? Anyways, what I want to talk about is the independent voter and why the independent voter should be leaning right. And I'm not going to get into all of the details, all of the scandals, all of the phony scandals, and all of this other crazy stuff that's going on in politics. I just want to talk about one concept that exists on the left, but not on the right. And that concept is political correctness. PC has gone from the redheaded stepchild to an insane 50-foot tall giant that is a bully. Political correctness wants to shut everyone up. Political correctness wants to be a trump on the First Amendment, free speech. Because you don't really have free speech if you're going to be intimidated by every possible person, every possible source, every possible communication that you could run into in a day. Everyone will look at you as the person that said that, the person that said this, that, the disrespectful, racist. You just can't have no respect for diversity and all that other PC garbage. But look at what it really is. It is a way to limit free speech because it eliminates discourse. Now, you can say, I'm the pot calling the kettle black because I don't debate liberals. I have a life. I don't have time. I have work 70 hours a week, two jobs. I try to maintain something that resembles a life, which I don't succeed at too well. I'm trying to help somebody get elected into state office. I'm trying to become more active in the party. So, no, I'm not going to get into some pseudo-intellectual debate with an idiot on Twitter when it's got a 140-character limit to begin with. It just doesn't make any sense to me. But the problem is there is no discourse. There is no open communication. And it's because of political correctness. Everyone I know hates political correctness. They think it's complete and utter BS, which it is. You do not have a right to shut down other people's opinions, whether you agree with it or not. And you definitely don't have the right just because you disagree with it, just because somebody finds it offensive and has labeled it taboo. And this concept of political correctness has gained a foothold. And it's not even a foothold, it's more like a foundation within the media, to where the media will only share its news stories in a politically correct manner. And by packaging it in such a manner with the illegal aliens anyways, they call them undocumented immigrants. Well, if you're an undocumented immigrant, that means you're an illegal alien. Because if you're undocumented, that means you're not legal. And they try to change the narrative to suit their purpose, to push it through. But this is what the root of political correctness is. It is intellectual dishonesty. There is nothing honest about political correctness. This is why they can't have a debate on it. This is why they want to shut you up. And this is why the independent voter should join with the conservative. You should ignore everything that is being said about those of us on the right. Because we love the Constitution. We love the country. We believe in our country. We're not warmongers. We're not racist. The only people we hate are those that don't love the USA. And many of those many of those of us on the right don't even hate those people. I'm one of them that do. I'm not going to deny it. I hate those on the left that will put the UN before the USA. I'm not ashamed of that. I admit it freely and clearly. I have no problem with it. But there are many, the vast majority of those of us on the right are such good-hearted people that they would still help those that we consider to be enemies of the United States of America. It doesn't make any sense to me. I would not help them. I will only help those who I believe are deserving of help. And I don't consider traitors to be deserving of help, but that's me. And that is our diversity. Our diversity is those who follow in the footsteps of Christ, and those of us who have too much anger in our hearts towards those we consider to be enemies to do so. Or, you know, the Jewish, agnostic, atheist, deist, Muslims, Hindus, and all the rest of us on the right of all these different faiths or lack of faith. We really are all over the place. We are straight. We are bisexual. We are gay. You just don't hear about that part of it. Just like you don't hear about how small of a minority the gay population truly is in the U.S. There have been polls taken, and people believe that 20 to 30% of all Americans are gay. No, 2 to 3%. It's just the media pushes it so much that people believe it's got to be a whole lot more. Well, it's part of the intellectual dishonesty of the left. They have to forward their agenda. They have to fight for every small percentage of the population so they can just keep their organization together, so they can hopefully stay in power, stay in control. Think about the radical Muslims that they have, the people that hate Israel. Most of us love Israel. Where would you rather visit? Would you rather visit Tel Aviv, that has a thriving government that is, for lack of a better word, it's a parliament. I'm not sure exactly what type of government. Representative democracy, probably. Yeah, it would be representative democracy. Or one of those other countries like Syria or Iraq or Yemen or even Libya and Egypt, with everything else that's going on there. There's a reason why the tourist industry in Egypt is suffering. It's because of the violence, because of the rape of Lara Logan. Westerners do not feel safe in that environment. Thusly, they do not go there and spend their money. The only ones that will go there are those that can afford their own private security, which are the most liberal of all. And they just have to prove that people are safe in a Middle Eastern country. The Muslims are our friends. They're not all radicals. Yeah, they let them have their Sharia law. And they get the feminist, to somehow believe that there is a war on women with conservatives. Show me one conservative woman that will let her husband walk on her like Hillary Clinton has let Bill walk on her. I can't think of one. I do not know one personally that would allow that BS to happen. I have met several beautiful, brilliant conservative women. Some are relatively well known, like Dana Lash. Others are just a little Twitter famous, and others are just simply nobody. Not one of them would turn around and stick with a man that has cheated multiple times. Now, depending on their faith and how long their relationship is, they may forgive him once. But how many times has Bill cheated? How many sexual scandals has followed Bill Clinton ever since he became governor? Not even what we don't know about before he became governor, or what we haven't heard about post-presidential, post-2000. And yet, Hillary sticks by him. Now, if they got some sort of weird relationship, that open marriage, fine, that's their business. But she really should should come out and say, well, we have an open marriage, so it's cool, I don't care. And people will go, whoa, that's weird, but whatever, if it works for you. And she would actually be able to maintain her aura of being a strong, independent woman. As it is, she looks like an abused spouse that has been walked on. And this is a person that the left wants to push upon us? This is the PC garbage that is being pushed on us? All of this? This is pure intellectual dishonesty. And I know I keep on repeating that phrase, but it is true. Intellectual dishonesty. Because as somebody has an undergrad in history, history is all about debate. And yet, the left preaches their version of U.S. history as fact, as the end all of history. December 7th, June 1941, Japan attacked Pearl Harbor. That is a fact. Exactly the cause that led to Japan attacking Pearl Harbor. Whether or not the U.S. had enough intelligence information to know the attack was coming and to be able to stop it, that is an argument. The left does not believe in the argument of history, in the debate of history. They only want to put forth their perception of what history is. End of story. By doing this, they have forwarded the agenda that the U.S. is wrong, the U.S. is evil, the U.S. is the great Satan, just like the radical Islamists do. We are the great Satan. In the liberals' eyes, and in the radical Muslims' eyes. Which is why the left keeps on trying to make atone for our sins. Well, if you actually go see Dinesh D'Souza's America, if you were lucky enough to see it, if not, buy it, get the book. That is an honest perception of history. Because he went to these people, these radicals, and got what they said about how the U.S. was evil, the U.S. was this, the U.S. was that. And then he put forth an alternative to say, no, it really isn't. You guys are just blowing things out of proportion. You can say that the U.S. has committed sins, but guess what? Every government ever has committed sins against its people and other people. You cannot find a single country that has ever existed. You cannot find a single government that has ever existed that has not done wrong to somebody. Well, I'm sorry for carrying on, I wanted this to be just a short little attack on PC and a call for the independents to join us on the dark side, because we got cookies. And I went off a little bit. I'm sorry. Just think about what I've said if you've actually listened to the entire 15, 16 minutes. And consider it. Because the truth is never simple. The truth is always complicated. Which is why when we have somebody go to court, it is a jury of their peers. And it is a very complicated effort. Both sides have representation. And it is moderated by a judge to ensure that both sides obey the law as the facts of the case, the perceived facts of the case, are given to the jury to digest and decide the fate of the defendant. This we have to understand. We have to accept. Life is not simple. NPC wants to make life simple. They want to make life very simple. Disturbingly simple. They want to paint the U.S. as wrong. They want to use guilt to get their agenda across, when their agenda is the same as any other political party, any other individual that seeks higher office. Their agenda is the same. It is personal power. And in the party, it is political power. Don't let them fool you. Because all of us, even you liberals that disagree with your own party, even you Democrats, I'm sorry, not the liberals, the Democrats, some of you, I won't even get into it, but even you Democrats have the power to take back your own party. You could turn it into a JFK party. You could turn it into the party of Jefferson. You could turn into the party of Jackson. But instead, you have the party of Obama. The party of Wasser Thing Schultz. That's not anything to be proud of. And that is why I do not trust a single Democrat. Because your party represents you. And if that is a mirror image of you, I don't want anything to do with you. So, those of us on the right, we have to gain control of our own party. Those of you in the middle, join us on the right. Help us gain control of our party. Help us keep the people in DC honest. Period. End of story. Thank you. And I'll finally end this. Good day to all of you, and God bless America.